So I'm heading over here to Vintage Kart Co. This is Ron's place. Oh my goodness. Look at that. Now there's a sight to behold. Woo! Look at all those beautiful machines. Boy, these guys love their cycle carts, I gotta tell you. Alright, let's check this out. Okay, so this is Vintage Kart Co. headquarters right here. And inside is where all the parts are made and then they're assembled. Jack right over there, he does all the painting. They just happen to have a 12-foot ladder out here in the parking lot, so makes for a good vantage point. That's Jack standing there in the doorway. They're shooting for 40 cars total. So, as many of you may already know, it was a year ago today when Napoleon contacted me. He'd seen the YouTube videos of us running around the house in our cars and asked if he could come over with his buddies and check it out. So they came to the house. There's a video of it. And we raced around, had a good time, became good friends. And then they decided they wanted to build cycle carts. So they didn't want to build a car that wasn't truly a cycle cart. So I lent them my cars. They brought them over here to the shop. And they measured them. They had them 2 or 3 months while they were measuring and getting everything right so that they stayed within the boundaries of what a cycle cart is. And I have to say, they did an outstanding job. You know, they started with the go-kart parts like we've all used in their first two prototypes, but then they subsequently decided they were just too sloppy and started developing components that were cycle cart related, like the rear hubs, front spindle, front axle, and then the motor plate with a differential. That was their biggest coup. They perfected that along with the braking system. So these are really nice cars now. So they've been really nice guys, and you know, I care for them all. You know, there's there's Napoleon and Andrew and Jack and Ron, and then there's Gary and Sean and Brett. So we've had a great time racing cycle carts around, and the other night at the volunteer meeting, they nicknamed me the Godfather. So I thought that was nice, because I'm about a dozen years older than the guys, so I'm the old man in the group. So okay, I'm the Godfather. Thanks guys, I like that. So for the Grand Prix, they're building 40 cars. 32 or 33 actual race teams, of which they've signed up 27, and they're getting the other signed up now. It's about a week away to the event. And then the balance of the cars are for promotional setups, like a Nickelodeon wants a couple cars, and there's a couple other companies that are going to have them on display. So the mad rush this coming week is to finish the last 15 cars or so, maybe less by the end of the day. I think there's 25 completely done, and there's a half a dozen that are real close to being done. So my plan is to help them out for the week and document the activities. It should be fun. This will be an historic event as I see it. Okay. You know, it's not every day you see a setup like this. So here's a bare chassis and tub, and they're just starting to put components together, assemble them onto the chassis. Eventually, they end up on one of these stands, and they put on all the components, And the last thing they install is the wheels. Then it's down on the ground and they install the body panels. So that's kind of the sequence of events. This one just came down off the stand, ready for its body panel. There's two more outside, and I test drove them, and they ran excellent. Yep, they take their cycle cart in serious.
We got a couple of these that we drilled out, remember? And I'm wondering if that one has extra clearance in it because the heat kept up.
But no, that's a brand new motor for this car.
I don't know. I would assume that the heat probably just is the same. Alright, so we got that.
And yeah, then, you know, it's the same with the brake. There's just some. I don't
know. This one brakes good.
Yeah.
Here's one of our lucky racers. This is his car, and he's taking delivery. We're about a week before the event. So he's going to practice with it this week. Lucky guy. That is a beautiful car. Now the lucky owner gets to take it for a little spin, and he's going to load it on his trailer. They're in the freezer. There is one happy guy. I'd be happy.
This steering is awesome. I like it.
Yeah. Brakes are sweet. Steering is awesome. These are really, really nicely built. Cycle carts are a family affair, that's for sure. So throughout the course of working on these from day to day, people stop by the shop, and of course they get to take the cars for a drive. That's Ron right there, doing some testing on the one they just finished. We've had a couple people stop by. There's some folks over there. This car is newly minted, finished 10 minutes ago. So Ron gets the honor of putting them through their paces. Of course, half the fun of building all these cars is every now and then you just gotta have some fun. So that's what they're doing. See if we can run into each other. Okay, I'm in the brand new one here. Let's see what she'll do. The brakes on these are good. Double skid marks. They really perfected this brake system. It's beautiful. These things cornered great. They got that differential, so vastly improved. Beautiful. Beautiful. Now that's a brake system, I gotta tell you. It's Sunday afternoon here at Vintage Kart Co. We just finished knocking a few things together. Still have a few more to do though, so we'll be here every day this week getting ready. This one here is about ready to come down off the rack. I like the blue with the yellow wheels. Oh, that's nice. So it's about 10 o'clock Monday night, and we're working on two cars here. They're a couple older cars we're converting from the go-kart manual brakes to the hydraulic brakes, getting these upgraded. I sure like the blue and yellow wheels on that car.
Way to trust me, not working.
All right, so we pulled out the old brakes, and now we're putting in the new setup. Much better than the go-kart. So it's Monday night over here at Vintage Kart Co, and the producers got together for a meeting, figuring out last minute things. Let's see, it's Tuesday night, and we're converting the older cars to juice brakes and putting in a new throttle, so that's the bulk of the work now. Every day to make room in the shop to build cars, they pull them outside. Of course, that gets people stopping by to see what's going on. Well, they look nice out here under the lights. So we're inside working, and it's been cloudy today, but it didn't look like it was gonna rain. 30% chance of rain. Well, then we had one of our classic 10-minute rain showers, and it just soaked the crap out of the cars. I guess they're all gonna get washed now. Oh man, it's always something, isn't it? Okay, so we pulled them all inside. We got a pretty good drenching.
Chris,
wet.
Got pretty wet. This is Ron's shop. There's his laser cutter. Cutting some 1-inch thick steel right now. It runs all night long. Pretty cool machine. Well, they wanted to wash them, so now they're getting a wipe down, so that'll actually probably save time that they got rained on. Since I'm the woodworker in the group, I made this base for the first place trophy. That's a grill off of one of their cars, and they're going to put the mesh in it, and it'll be painted. I just put the flag in there for the heck of it. But this is walnut. Plywood, walnut veneer plywood, and hardwood, walnut hardwood with a satin finish, lacquer finish on the underside. So the idea is that this little base unscrews and is removable, and then over time, bear with me here. So over time, it's going to grow in height as they have, as the years go by. And they're going to put plaques on here of the winning race teams. On the rear here, this back is removable. And the inaugural year, first year winners will be on the back with probably brass plaques. So anyway, this will grow like the Stanley Cup. It'll just grow in height and become quite a trophy over the years. They're gonna put a ornament on here. They gotta polish it one more time. It's taking kind of a beating. But that'll make for a decent first place trophy, I think.
Hey,
You like that trophy, huh?
I love it, Dennis.
Well, it's hump day. It's Wednesday. So, more cars to build, more things to get ready. I'm drilling out the front axle for a cotter pin required by the insurance company.
How's your day, Dennis?
It's good.
A little wet.
Make sure you get my good side.
You don't have a good side.
Right, I don't. Don't rub it in.
You have a good side.
That's Chris on the right and Braden on the left. Master mechanic. Masters, it's scrounging up what you need in here, right?
Gotta make it work.
There goes Bob Miller out the door. So we take the powder coat out of the inside so it'll clear this hub here. See, now it's sitting in there real nice. So I have to do that to the other side. Here's the ring for the other side. Slightly smaller because it's on the inside. Okay, so I gotta clean that one up. You have to take the powder coat off the inside of this so it'll fit in the hub. Here's Bob Miller's in Phoenix. Just arrived an hour or two ago. All right. And he's been here 10 minutes and now he's driving a car. All right. It's a Wednesday night. Okay, it's Wednesday night. And, Bob Miller, he's over there on his hands and knees wrenching on a cart. He was here for 5 minutes and we put him in a car to drive and 10 minutes later he's wrenching. But it's a mad rush. It's Wednesday night, so a couple more, really, all the cars have to be over to the track on Friday. So, got one more tonight and tomorrow night, so see what we're doing tonight. Oh, here's the Ninja Turtle car. This is a vinyl wrap. Nice. It really is nice. It opens up a new dimension being able to do a vinyl wrap. Of course, you saw the rat rod in photos. That's going to be a fun car. So we just bled the brakes. We got to put the wheels on these three here, and they'll be down on the ground.
That's one to tighten up.
These cars are a little tricky to put together, but after a while you get the hang of it. So we've got us one of the cars, the differential is leaking oil in the center of the case. It's the only one out of 40 that's leaking, so we're trying to figure out why. It's got to be something that's loose.
I don't care about the rotors.
Well, oh yeah, but keep in mind that could have migrated because I started spraying. Okay, you follow me. So what I got to do is I'll pull the caliper, I'll clean the whole rotor up, slide it up on the springs, and I'll get my caster that way, which gives me a little bit.
There's Gary. There's Ron. There's Jack. There's Chris right there. There's Braden, and then the customer is over there. That's his race car. So they were out practicing with it tonight, and a little problem creeped up with the differential. So the mechanics are getting on it. They're discussing the leaking differential and how to repair it. So it's Thursday night, so it doesn't have to be fixed by tomorrow, but the day after tomorrow. And to change the differential or to get to it, you have to remove quite a bit of stuff. So they're developing a strategy.
Well, but it's different because we take these bolts out,
right?
Because it doesn't come apart. Well, yeah, just it actually just falls right apart.
It's a little bit longer bolt, and that bolt captures that.
11 o'clock at night. Having some fun with the cycle guards. That's Jack's brother. So, it doesn't matter what time of day or night, we drive. I love it. Ninja Turtle car. Bumblebee. Nice cars, huh? Right on. So there's been an interesting development. It's Thursday night, as I've stated before. And Napoleon, most all the guys are here, but Napoleon came up to me and said, would you like to race? And I said, you bet I'd like to race. He says, all right, well, gather up some names of some people you want on your team, and you guys can drive the in-ground trampoline car in the race. So Bob Miller, he's going to be part of it. I am, my wife, my daughter, my son-in-law, and my buddy Brian. We're going to be the drivers of the in-ground trampoline car. I'm pretty excited about that. So I'm here at the Hyatt Regency. This is the mandatory driver's training session. Everybody has to drive or you don't, has to be here at some point over the next 2 days or you don't get to race. So I'm going to do my laps, just a little course, make sure everybody's had a little time behind the wheel. All right, baby, we're going to race. So outside here at the gala, they have most of the cars here. They have them spread around all over the plaza for photo opportunities and the like. There's some down on the level over there. And then there's some on the upper level. There's the start-finish line there. That's a bridge over the canal. So we'll be racing right up through here and over that bridge down by the horse statue there. So everybody's dressed up, having a good time. And it's a perfect evening. The weather is outstanding. Gatsby Gala in between the fans taking a break. Everybody dressed up in 20s attire. So we're having a good time here at the gala. Dorinda!
A big noise playing in the street, gonna be a big man someday. You got mud on your face, you big disgrace, kicking your can all over the place, singing,
we will rock you.
A big disgrace, waving your banner all over the place.
We will.